After gastrulation, which we were talking about in the previous video, the embryo goes through changes and forms a three-layered disc. This disc consists of the ectodermal, mesodermal, and endodermal germ layers. The embryo's posterior-anterior axis is determined by a variety of molecules and a structure called the primitive streak forms at the posterior side. As development progresses, the primitive streak regresses and disappears. At the same time, the ectoderm layer starts forming something called the neural plate. This neural plate is crucial because it eventually becomes the brain and spinal cord, which make up the central nervous system. The formation of the neural plate involves a series of complex processes at the molecular and cellular level. BMP4 is a crucial protein involved in the development of the nervous system. In the primitive streak stage, the primitive node starts releasing two signals, noggin and cordin. These signals act as inhibitors of BMP, which creates a gradient of BMP in the embryo. This gradient helps establish the dorsal-ventral axis, which is an important reference for development. Now, by default, in the absence of the BMP signal, the ectoderm would give rise to neural tissue. If you remember from this video, Madeline Lancaster discussed how they create brain organoid using a medium known as neural induction medium. However, she later clarified that this medium is actually a simple one without any specific signaling molecules. Now, without BMP4, the ectoderm undergoes changes, including elongation and thickening, which ultimately forms a structure called the neural plate. The neural plate then folds laterally, giving rise to the neural tube. Additionally, during this process, certain cells separate from the neural tube and are referred to as neural crest cells. Once the neural tube is formed, it undergoes a process called segmentation, which divides it into different segments, forebrain, midbrain, and hindbrain spinal cord segments. In a previous video, it was mentioned that the anterior visceral endoderm plays a significant role in establishing the anterior-posterior axis. Another structure called the precordal plate is formed during gastrulation and is also responsible for patterning and axis formation. Both the precordal plate and anterior visceral endoderm are crucial for the development of the head structure. Together with the notochord, they send signals to the neural tube. In response to these signals, the anterior and posterior parts of the neural plate begin expressing a specific gene, such as OTX2, which is associated with the future forebrain and midbrain, and GBX2, which is related to the hindbrain and spinal cord. There are several signaling molecules involved in the development and differentiation of the nervous system. Although I won't go into detail about all of them, two molecules play a specifically important role in the elongation of the spinal cord during early development. When the neural plate forms, the cells located at the posterior part possesses the characteristic of neural stem cells. Adjacent to the neural plate, the mesoderm layer releases a signaling molecule called FGF8. This molecule promotes the self-renewal of these neural stem cells, helping them maintain an undifferentiated state. This specific mesoderm layer is known as the paraxial mesoderm, which we will discuss in a future video. Moving towards the anterior axis, the paraxial mesoderm releases a different set of signals called retinoic acid, which is an active form of vitamin A. RA inhibits the effect of FGF8 and triggers the differentiation of neural stem cells into neurons. So the part of the ectoderm that is not affected by BMP4 makes the neural ectoderm, which is going to make the neural plate and neural tube. The neural tube then gives rise to the brain and spinal cord, as well as other structures like the retina, epiphysis, and posterior pituitary. But the part of the ectoderm that has high levels of BMP becomes non-neural ectoderm, which gives rise to many structures such as suite and mammary gland, hair, nails, and the epithelium. Ectodermal cells that are exposed to intermediate levels of BMP develop molecular characteristics that feed neither those of the neural plate nor the surface ectoderm. The neural crest is one of these cells, which eventually differentiate and make different structures such as pigment cells, sensory nerves, and Schwann cells. In future videos, I will talk about the fate of mesoderm and endoderm, but until then, thank you for watching.